Yes, madame.
Charles, I'm going out. Order me a carriage immediately. Charles!
Yes, madame. Right away, madame.
Repeat that again, please.
She doesn't want to.
She doesn't want to?
She doesn't want to.
Such stupidity is without equal in the entire history of human relations. Must be your fault. It must be. You must have emphasized all the difficulties instead of the delights. What did you say to the little monster?
Oh, no, Alicia. Gigi is perhaps a little slow about certain things, but just because she's not attracted to Gaston Lachat doesn't make her a little monster.
It doesn't make her a little princess. What did you say to her? Did you tell her about love, travel, moonlight, Italy, about hummingbirds in all the flowers, and making love in a gardenia-scented garden?
I couldn't tell her that, Alicia. I've never been further than the Riviera.
Couldn't you have invented it?
No, Alicia, I could not.
It's incredible. Incredible! Where is she? Perhaps I should talk to her again and tell her what she's missing. It's the glory of romance. Forgetting everything in the arms of the man who adores you. Listening to the music of love in an eternal spring.
And when eternal spring is over?
What difference does that make?
It makes a great difference to Gigi, and shall I tell you something? I'm not sure I don't agree with her.
You're a fool! And your granddaughter takes after you. Oh, when I think of the time and effort I've lavished on that idiotic child, when I think...
Gaston!
I received a note from Gigi. She said she wanted to see me.
Of course. Of course. Won't you come in?
Thank you.
You know my sister?
My dear Mr. Lachat, what a pleasant surprise. And how is your enchanting father?
He has diabetes.
Well, if one is in the sugar business and your attractive mother, well, I hope.
Gaston, I have been thinking. I'd rather be miserable with you than without you.